Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello friends, in the last lecture we have did what is bond enthalpy and we have did a numerical on that too. And now let us do the another kind of numerical which is based on bond enthalpy. So let us do it. So this is a question which is based on bond enthalpy. So let us understand the question. So they are saying that we have to calculate the carbon and chlorine bond that has an enthalpy from the reaction that is CH3Cl plus Cl2, that should give us CH2Cl2 plus HCl. And in this process, that is the enthalpy of the reaction, or the standard enthalpy of the reaction, is been found to be minus 104 kilojoule. As well as they have also provided us the data of like bond enthalpy of carbon and hydrogen, that is 414, chlorine atom and fluorine atom, that is 243, and that of HCl, it has been given as 431. So in this process, basically all the data are been given to us, and in this case we have to one more thing that I have to mention is the states. Yes, the states are being present in a gaseous state, whether it would be chlorine gas or whether it would be HCl gas, all are being present in a gaseous state. And from that case, I have to calculate what would be the bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine atom. So let us calculate this thing. But before calculation, we should understand that how can we represent the reaction, because by representing the reaction, it would be very much easy to understand that how many and which kind of bond are being present in the reactant as well as in the products. So first of all, it was being given as CH3Cl, that is, can be written as this format, plus the chlorine gas, that can be written as the bond between chlorine atom and chlorine atom in this way, and that should give us CH2Cl, that could be written as CH2Cl2, and that of HCl is also been given. And in this case we could calibrate, or we could represent the bond between H and Cl as this one. So now every data has been provided to us, and it would be very much easy to calculate what would be the bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine atom. So in this case, let us understand what is the formula and how can we derive the formula in this equation. So we have basically the relation between the enthalpy of reaction, that is delta H of reaction, which is equals to summation of enthalpy of product and enthalpy of reactant, that is we have. But in this case, since we are calculating the bond enthalpies, so therefore the delta H naught of reactant bonds minus summation of delta H naught of product bonds. So by analyzing this reactants and these are the products, so we could easily write that how much kind of bonds are been present in this reactants. So as you could see, that is when we are talking about that is CH3Cl, and in this case, or methyl chloride, that we know that in this case basically the carbon and hydrogen bond that we are observing, as well as the carbon and chlorine bond that we are observing. So but carbon and hydrogen bond that are been present, they are present three times, therefore I could write it as 3 into delta H naught bond between carbon and hydrogen, plus I could see one bond of that is between one covalent bond that is between carbon and chlorine atom, so that 4 plus 1 into delta H naught of carbon and chlorine atom. So this was for their first reactant, but the another reactant is also been remaining, that is chlorine and chlorine, so or the bond between chlorine atoms. So we could also write it as 1 into delta H naught of chlorine and chlorine atom. So this is what we have got. And so this was for the reactant, but for the product also we can easily calculate. And in this case, what we can do is we know the value of 2 into that is hydrogen atom as well as a chlorine atom, the bond that we have, that is hydrogen and that is carbon, plus we have 2 times that of the bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine. Plus, in this case, as we could see that we have one bond of between HCl, so therefore one times that of delta H naught of HCl. So this is the formula that we have made to calculate what would be the bond enthalpy between carbon and chlorine. So now the thing that we have to do is we have to substitute the values in this case, and let us see what we will get. So the delta H value of the reaction that has been given to us as basically minus 104 kilojoules, while that of the when we'll move further, so therefore since we have to multiply 3 into that of the bond enthalpy of carbon and hydrogen, so therefore 3 into bond enthalpy of carbon and hydrogen that they have provided to us is basically 414. So therefore I could write it as 414 here and make it in a bracket form. So moving towards the another one, that is 1 into delta H naught of CnCl. So therefore we have the CnCl, that is the thing that we have to calculate. So we don't have that value, so therefore we could calculate that also by making it as it is, or by writing it as it is. And talking about the next thing that we have in this case is we have the bond enthalpy of chlorine and chlorine, and in this case that is also provided to us, that is 243. So this is the thing that we have did for the reactants. So now what we have to, subtract this from the product, bond enthalpy of the products. So in this case basically the product that we have, so we could easily calculate, that is 2 into H, delta H naught of hydrogen and carbon. So what I'll do is 2 multiply by the delta H of that is bond enthalpy of carbon and hydrogen that has been given as 414. Plus in this case we have to calculate, we don't have the value of that is delta H naught of CCl. This is the value that we don't have. So I'm again I'll sum up with the value of HCl that we have to do. So therefore 1 times that of the bond enthalpy of the HCl that we have is basically 431. So this is 431 that we have. So we could easily calculate this thing. So first of all let me first of all calculate all those numbers here, and we could rearrange this thing so as to calculate what would be the value of the bond enthalpy between carbon and chlorine atom. So after calculating this thing, let us see what we could get. So for this value we have got a value as 1485 plus delta naught that is bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine. And talking about this one, suppose if minus has been multiplied in the whole thing, so we could easily calculate this things as, so we have got a value of basically, if we have added this thing with 431, so we have got basically 1259 plus 2 times of delta H naught of bond between carbon and Cl. So we could rearrange this thing in a format of 1485 plus bond enthalpy between hydrogen between carbon and chlorine minus 1259. Again this minus would become come over here, so therefore this would become 2 into delta H naught of CCl. So by arranging this the value thus in the, and if we simplify this thing, so let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got basically 226. So now what we are going to do, we are going to rearrange this thing. So in this case, suppose if 1 times of delta H naught of CCl, that is the bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine in this case, and minus 2 times of the bond enthalpy of carbon and chlorine in this case, we could make it as basically 1 minus 2, that is basically nothing but minus 1. So therefore we could write it as minus of, that is delta H naught of CCl. So now it would be very much easy to calculate this thing. So the thing that we have to do is we have to rearrange it. So for that we have basically minus 104, which is equals to 226 minus of delta H naught of the bond enthalpy between carbon and chlorine atom. So this is what we have. So now if we rearrange this thing, so it would be written as 104 minus 226, which is equals to minus delta H naught of carbon and chlorine. So if we arrange this thing, so let us see what is the answer that we could get. So we have got a value of minus 330 kilojoule, but this had also a value of a sign of minus that was attached to it. So what the thing that I have to do is I'll cancel out this thing. So the answer that we have got is basically delta H naught, or the bond enthalpy between carbon and chlorine in this case, is found to be 330 kilojoule. So this is how we could calculate what is the bond enthalpy of a particular covalent bond between the two atoms by using the formula of the enthalpy of the reaction, as well as the bond enthalpy of the reactants, as well as for the products also. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope this numerical was easy and you'll try to do more kind of numericals like this, and share this video with your friends, and yes, don't forget to subscribe BK channel. Thank you so much.